Very important question. We'll end, inshallah, after this question. هل ممكن الصيام بدون الصلاة? Is it permissible that a person fasts but doesn't pray? Brothers, it's like building a house starting from the roof. Have you ever seen a house built from the roof? If you have, as I said, I just finished my psychiatrist course. You could be my first customer. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, As-salatu imad al-deen. As-salatu imad al-deen. Prayer is the foundation. I beg the brothers and sisters, please pray. I beg you for the sake of Allah. Don't cut the relationship between you and Allah. Praying, salat, it's called salat in Arabic. It is a connection between you and the Creator. If this relationship is cut, your life is full of misery. The Prophet, peace be upon him, while he was dying, his soul is exiting his body, he used to say, As-salatu, salatu, salat. Pray, pray, pray. Some of the brothers and sisters, some sisters say, well, I'm not wearing hijab. Once I wear the hijab, I'd pray. Some of the brothers could be gambling or drinking alcohol or good, they could be doing bad things. They would say, once I'll abstain from this, I'll pray. I would say, my dear brothers and sisters, pray even though that you are doing this major sin that I've just mentioned. Because prayer will help you to abstain from the major sin. When you have a connection with Allah, when you create this connection and you ask Allah, oh Allah, please help me to come out of these drugs that I'm taking, whether it's speed or amphetamine or whatever. Please Allah, improve my relationship between me and my wife. Please Allah, make the relationship between me and my children better. Oh Allah, please make the relationship between me and my employer better. Make the relationship between me and my workers. Ask Allah constantly. This is the time, my dear brothers and sisters. The closest you are to Allah when you're prostrating, when this head is on the ground and you ask Allah for forgiveness. And you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow whatever you wish. The closest, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَقْرَبْ مَا يَكُونَ الْعَبْدِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٍ. The closest that a person can be to Allah when they're prostrating, when they admit that they are weak and Allah is the most mighty. When they are in the lowest position and Allah is the most high. Subhan Rabbi al-A'la. Glory to He, He is most high. And then you ask Him, Ya Rabb, اغفر لي. Ya Rabb, arhamni. Ask Allah, oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, have mercy upon me. Oh Allah, grant my parents paradise. Oh Allah, forgive their sins. Oh Allah, make my friend Joe a good Muslim. Ask. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ للعالمين. And we've only sent you to be merciful on all mankind. A good opportunity. You know, when you're telling a non-Muslim about Islam, then you go back and you do the other part. Okay, you've done the first part as conveying the message of Islam to them. Now go back and ask Allah, Oh Allah, show him the truth. Oh Allah, remove from his heart enmity and hatred that has been built through the media and through some silly politicians. And through some silly Muslims' actions and behavior. You know, it's very easy for us to always blame, you know. The politicians are saying this and the media is saying this. And we are to blame first. The Muslims are to blame first. What is taking place at the moment, the Muslims are to blame first. Okay, and we have to recognize. We should stop pointing out this way, saying the Jews, the Christians, the Muslims. We should point out this way first. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ. Allah does not change the situation of people until you change yourselves. When we change ourselves, the community will change. You see the difference between Muslims and non-Muslims. We Muslims change ourselves depending on what is in the Quran and the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And other beliefs, they change their books to suit their way of life. Again, allow me to say this again. The Muslims change their way of lives to befit what is in the Quran, the words of Allah, and the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is best. And Allah knows best. And Allah knows what is beneficial for us. But other belief, they change their books to see what benefits them. This is something that we need to keep in mind. May Allah reward you and strengthen you all. I do apologize. There's another half a kilo of questions, but inshallah.